Welcome to the .3D 5.0 and up registration tutorial. This video will cover the process of aligning two .3D scans to each other within .3D. With the larger scene capture sizes and append capabilities now available in .3D 5.0 and up, this process may not be necessary as frequently, but in any case, here's how you do link multiple .3D scans using April tags when they've been captured separately. First, it's important to note that you do need to have at least three overlapping April tag targets between the two scans in order to complete this process as outlined here. While four or five targets overlapping would be even better, the minimum is three. And more importantly, you do want to make sure that these tags are reasonably spread out on different surfaces and elevations within that overlapping area. While there are, of course, limitations to how far you're going to spread them out within this overlapping section, it is important to space them as much as you can and put them at those different elevations. AKA, what you really don't want to do is just put three April tags right next to each other and rely on that for registration, because it will be much less accurate than if they were scattered a little bit further apart from each other. So the first step here is going to be to open the reference scan, or your first scan that you're going to be registering your next scan back to. In this case, it could be either of these two scans, since it's just a two scan registration. If it was a higher number of scans that you're registering altogether, then you want to plan ahead and try and pick the centermost scan and ideally reference each of the additional scans back to that centermost scan, which is what we call the spider method. All right, so now that we've covered the basics and the setup process, let's go ahead and open one of our two scans and begin the workflow. You'll notice that both scans in this case have already been optimized. That is normally the case for this process because you've already achieved the maximum levels of accuracy through optimization for each individual scan, applying any relevant constraints during the optimization stage. And now we're just referencing the two scans to each other. So the next step when you open your first scan is to create a coordinate system or reference a coordinate system that's going to be applied to both scans after the registration. So in this case, we're just going to go to Edit Coordinates and set a user-defined coordinate system. This process is covered in other tutorials, but we'll cover it again quickly here. So you pick your origin point by tapping and holding and using the zoom window in the top right. You release when you're happy, and that'll be your 000 point. Then you press the primary button and hold on the floor to set your z-axis straight up, and press the secondary button and hold on any wall or surface to pull from to set your x-axis out of that wall. If you want to then toggle between the x or the y coming out of the wall, you can use the buttons on the bottom as I'm showing now. Once you're happy with the coordinate system that's set, you want to press confirm, and that now becomes your 000 origin point that'll carry through both scans after registration. Next, we're going to move over to the targets tab where we can export the April tags that have been recognized from scan 1 and create a text file that can easily then be brought right into scan 2. So you just press the export tags button and follow the prompts on the screen to export in the user-defined coordinate system to a TXT file on your device. Now, before we move on to scan 2, we of course want to save our work. So we'll just go to File, Save, and save this scene to the new coordinate system, and then open scan 2. Now, we don't have to go to the coordinates tab in this case because that's going to be pulled from our targeting file. So we'll go straight to the targets tab and load control file. Now you can open control file and load in the TXT file that was just created from our first scan and press import. And then press fit control targets to apply the coordinates from the first scan to the second scan based on overlapping tags. The registration process is now complete, and a new output transform will be available when you go to Save Scan 2 by checking control targets during the save or export process. So now that the registration is complete, let's take a look at the results. In this case, an Autodesk recap. You do need to open the scans in third-party software to see them registered together. Currently, there is no way to visualize multiple DP scans at the same time within Dot3D. However, note that this will be changing in the future, so please stay tuned there. During the Autodesk recap import process, you want to check the Advanced tab and make sure the decimation is brought down to zero to maintain the full density of your scans before proceeding and then indexing scans. You see the two scans in the top left now loading into Autodesk recap. And once both of those circular bars have filled, you can press Launch Project on the bottom right and take a look at scan 1 and scan 2 rendered seamlessly together here in Autodesk recap. If you want to move on to AutoCAD, Revit, etc., you would export an RCS file from here, which can also be exported from .3D on Windows. If exporting to a unified RCS here from Recap, you also want to make sure to check the decimation setting on Export 2. By default, it will try and decimate your scan on the way out as well.